some tools to help us activate our soul purpose. Ways to get there? Here are some tools for your toolbox. Okay, exercise. Exercise and diet. This is the vessel. This is the vessel that contains our soul, our spirit. And we may think that it's operating on its own, that the body is just doing things naturally. Or we may think the mind is telling the body what to do. And a lot of times we equate the brain with the mind. And I invite you to consider that they're not necessarily the same thing, that the mind may not be confined to one organ within your body. I invite you to consider that. Nonetheless, this is what we're given. Now, we don't have to look a certain way. We don't have to be a certain way in terms of what the world expects, in terms of what the world defines as how a body should be. That's got nothing to do with who we are. Our job, when we're looking after our body and looking after ourselves, is to make it the best we can. Physically strong, physically healthy, do what we can. And we can't just do it from this level. The mind activates what's going on in the body. And what can control the real thoughts, if you will, the truer thoughts that are coming into your mind? Of course, the spirit. So once we're taking care of our body, how do we get access to the spirit? First of all, let's clear the mind of the garbage. The mind has mental chatter going on all the time. We have more conversations on a daily basis with ourselves than we do of anyone, ever. So some of it, well, actually about 98% of it, is really just noise. It's chatter. It's the pain points. It's the ego. It's whatever word you want to call it, going after us, telling us all of the things we are not. The way to change that around is to get clear, to get rid of the chatter as best as you can. Meditation is a great way to do that. And no, I don't mean sitting under the lotus tree and cross or in lotus position under the Bodhi tree all day long in woo-woo land. I mean a practical practice of meditation on a regular basis. Even if it's sitting with your eyes closed, your feet firmly planted on the floor, taking several deep breaths and trying to clear your mind. Now, when you first start this, it's crazy because you might take two breaths and then suddenly your mind's gone off on a tangent. Oh, I got to remember to go pick up the dry cleaning. And oh, let's have salmon for dinner tonight. And oh. Don't worry about it. Just let it pass. Don't be hard on yourself if this doesn't happen overnight. Make it a regular practice. And we're going to be talking about how to combine those together so that you can make it a regular practice. Spiritual. What is your spiritual base? And again, I'm not talking about your religion and your religious beliefs, but what do you know about this thing we call spirit? What do you know about this thing we call soul purpose? Where can you go to find out more information? Who has access to information that you might be interested in? I encourage you to check out some of these amazing authors who have not only books, but they have audio recordings and video recordings. And we'll be talking about some very specific people that you can check out initially. And once you start the ball rolling, well, it's endless. You can pick and choose what will work best for you. Also, asking better questions. Instead of asking, what's wrong with me? Why is this happening to me? Why not ask, whose belief or thought is this? If you have a belief about a particular type of person, let's say you watch someone walking by who's 50 pounds overweight, and you have a belief about that person that basically says, oh, they're so big, they're so heavy, they must be lazy, they must be disgusting, their hygiene habits must be terrible. Don't beat yourself up about it, and don't feel bad or guilty for having that thought roaming around in your head. Take a minute and say, whose thought is that? Where did that belief come from? And try and answer that specifically. Odds are really good the belief was never yours to begin with. It was given to you by perhaps your parents, perhaps your teachers, perhaps your friends when you were young. Odds are it's a belief you've adopted as your own over the years that may not serve you anymore. It's limited, and its limitation has run out. So that goes to this question here. Does it serve me now? Does this belief really serve me now? So that pretty much wraps it up for connecting to spirit, connecting to soul purpose, the foundation, the driving engine behind all the rest, all the other three steps. Tomorrow we'll talk about step number two, or in our next video, we'll talk about step number two, and that has to do with you getting clear about what you want to be, who you are, and more importantly, who you are not. I'm Lori F. Dean, and we'll catch you next time.